read about the purification process of the leper, the Torah tells us that the Kohen goes out of the camp where the leper is located to evaluate the lesion, whether it's healed or not. He goes bichutz lamachne. So over here, the Reish Lakish explains it based on an illusionary level, based on the Zohar. Ubderech remes tirmos haparsha al golus Yisrael. What the parsha is alluding to is the golus, the exile of Klal Yisrael. Al derech omrib sefer Zohar. Yumus ha'olam li Yisrael him bechinas ha'tzaras. Just as the tzaras, the leprosy, consumes the person, identically, when we're in exile, the nations of the world consume us. V'sheyishlu b'hem l'tzaratam atzmo, sh'sovi v'tzaras. And the reason why we're vulnerable to their persecutions and to their dominance is for the same reason why we're subject to tzaras. V'timza gamki sh'omru sh'lo niglu Yisrael mi'mitzrayim. The reason why we married the Gula from Egypt, because there were among all the Jews, people did not speak Lashon Hara. Where do we see this? Chsiv, Vishali Isha Meis, Rusa, a woman had to borrow from her fellow the vessels, the gold vessels, the silver, the special clothing, and the men. Prior to actually borrowing, it was known among them. The word never got out, they never shared it with anybody. They were so in control of their speech. In the merit of that, we merited Gula. Gam eilucha dovish emarchik odom min kono k'loshon hara. There's nothing which furthers a person from HaKadosh Baruch Hu like Loshon Hara. Ulzeh omra Torah, zosti Torah samitzora. Shehu am Yisrael, Torah shenitztareya benigei b'nei odom atmeim. The Jew who has been contaminated with these nether forces, Yom Taroso, Yitar Lushono. What is Yom Taroso? When he purifies his tongue, when he does tshuva on Lashon Hara, and he ceases to speak Lashon Hara, that will activate the Gula. That will precipitate the coming of Mashiach, as you will explain. The Chofetz Chaim writes that a person speaks Lashon Hara, it activates the greatest level of prosecution. Why? Because the Satan continuously wants to prosecute our record, except because the Misa Rachmim, HaKadosh Baruch Hu says, I don't want to hear from it. Regardless of the record being floored, until the record is prosecuted, is audited, there's no consequence of the record. But if the Satan is able to prosecute, we have an issue. That's known as Midas Adin. So the Satan comes to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, says, I understand you don't want me to prosecute your children, but your children themselves, they're speaking Lashon Hara about one another. They're bringing up, they're pointing out negative information where it has no constructive value. HaKadosh Baruch Hu has nothing to say to Satan. He says, prosecute the record. As a result of we failing in this area, this activates the most serious level of prosecution. That's Golus. And that's many terrible things. He cites the Zohar. It's Cherev. It's death. It's suffering. It's illness. So whoever speaks Lashon Hara, all that, these very serious ramifications are attributed to the person who speaks Lashon Hara. The death and everything else. Therefore, a person who speaks Lashon Hara, it's marchiko. So it causes a distance between HaKadosh Baruch Hu and Klal Yisrael. Now, what's Uvo HaKohen? El Bichutz LaMachner. The Kohen is HaKadosh Baruch Hu. He will go chutz lamachne, he's going to chutz loretz. He's going outside of Eretz Yisrael to locate his children, to bring us back from Golus. And who's the, and he says it, he takes shnei tziporim, he takes two birds. V'tziva ha-koev lokach lemetar shnei tziporim chayos, ha-toras heim shnei mashichim. These are the two Mashiachs, Mashiach ben Yosef and Mashiach ben David. V'nikru tzipor, why they refer to as birds? Chayim yitkenu nishmos el yonim skiyodua, because the most exalted neshamos are referred to as the birds. V'odbotzinu sheyiskane ha-goel k'tzipor. We find that the goel, the old man goel, is identified as a bird. Zeloshna Zohar Pashas Bolok Ubayahi Maroso Yiske Chad Ofer Raver Voilo, from that special cave will come one large bird, exalted, the Yishol B'chol Alma, who will dominate the world, V'le'yisyov Malchusa, and to him he will be given the kingship of the world. U'matzisha Amru Sheshnei Meshichi Yisrael Hein, Meshich Ben Ephraim, Meshich Ben David, U'betchili Yizgale Meshich Ben Ephraim, V'yomos. He will fight the battle against Gog and Magog, the Armageddon, and he will be killed in the battle. V'achach Yizgale Meshich Ben David, and then Meshich Ben David will be revealed. U'keneged Shnei Elu, so to correspond to these two Meshichim, Omar v'lokach l'mitar shnei tziporim chayus toros, he will take two kosher species of birds. Kol elu kunuyim mailus hakedusha, this identifies their exalted level of kedusha. Ki yodu l'yodidas, and then he continues, one you slaughter the first bird, and then you, the other bird you dip into its blood and you send it into the wild. The slaughtering of the first bird, that is the death, that's the killing of Mashiach ben Yosef at war. However, it's cited, the Gaon, it translates the various things we say on Hallel. We pray, it's possible Mashiach ben Yosef will not be killed. And we supplicate Hashem, Dovid HaMelech wrote in Tehillim, praying that despite the fact that he's prone to be killed, that Hashem should have rachmim, he should not be killed, and that will be the ultimate level of gula that will have both, although Mashiach ben David is the primary Mashiach. Amen.